Welcome students. As a human being, everyone like festival, isn't it? We will enjoy during the festival, especially children. Every one of you enjoy and you are eagerly waiting for any festivals, isn't it? Here, in this lesson also, we are going to learn about a festival, Eid. Okay, here, in this lesson, about Hamid, a poor boy, and his granny. Granny means grandmother. Okay, now we can let us see the lesson. How wonderful and beautiful was the morning of Eid. The trees looked greener, the field more festive, the sky had a lovely pink glow, the sun seemed brighter and more dazzling than before to wish the world a very happy Eid. Especially nature means it is beautiful only, but especially during the festival we will enjoy with the nature, isn't it? So the early morning of the Eid, the sun comes to wish a very happy Eid. Okay, then the village was filled with excitement. Everyone was up early to go to the Eidgah. The boys were more excited than the others. They had been talking about it all the time. Finally, the day had come and now they were impatient. They were taking their treasure out of their pockets, counting and recounting it before putting it back. Mahmud counted 1, 2, 10, 12. He had 12 coins. Mohsin had 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 15 coins. With this money, they would buy countless things, toys, sweets, paper pipes, rubber balls, and much more. Okay. Now, this is the explanation of the Eid day, what they did. Okay. The early morning, everyone got up early morning and they are eagerly waiting to go to the Eidgah. And especially the boys, they were excited so much and they had talking about only the festival up to the day come. Okay. So, one day, the day had come, but now they are eagerly waiting for the celebration. Okay. So, everyone has had a pocket money. Okay, so they met their friends and they counted their pocket money. In among them, Mahmud, he had 12 coins and Mohsin had 15 coins and they had planned what shall we do. Mahmud had 12 coins, Mohsin had 15 coins. They had planned what to do and what to buy from this money. Okay, among them one poor boy, Hamid, also there. Okay, the happiest of the boys was Hamid. He was only 4, thin and poorly dressed. Last year his father had died of cholera, then his mother also died. From then Hamid lived with his old granny Amina and was as happy as a lark. She told him that his father had gone to earn money and that his mother had gone to Allah to get lovely gift for him. This made Hamid very happy. Hamid had no shoes on his feet. The cap on his head was soiled and tattered. He knew that his father would come back with a sack full of silver and his mother with a gift from Allah. Then he would have more than Mahmud, Mohsin, Nure and Sami. Okay, so already I said Hamid was a very poor boy. He had no parents. Actually the last year, the previous year, his father was died because of cholera. And then after that his mother also died. Okay, so no one gave the money to him. But he was happy because his grandmother didn't say about his parents to him, because if she say means he may feel very sad, isn't it? So his grandmother didn't say about his parents. She said about his father, he had gone to earn money. Okay, and mother went to Allah to bring the gift for him. Okay, so she was very happy like a lark. Lark means it is a bat, it is the happiest bat, like a bird. He used to do sing, and always he walk with a smiling face, and he will sing a nice song like a bat. Okay, because he was very happy about his parents. The real situation he didn't know because of his grandmother. She didn't say anything to him. So he imagined that one day if his father came, means he will have the lot of money, better than Mohsin, Nure and Sami. Okay, and Hamid's granny Amina was sad. It was Eid and she did not have even a handful of grains. If only her son were there, it would have been a different kind of Eid. Hamid went to his grandmother and said, "Granny, I will be the first to get back. Don't worry." Amina was worried. Other boys were going out with their fathers. How could she let him go to the fair all by himself? Okay, but his granny knew everything about her son. So she was very sad what to do for this day. But Hamid was happy. Okay, so she said to Hamid, "Don't go anywhere." But Hamid said, "Okay, I will go and I will come back very soon." Okay, but she was very sad about Hamid. Okay, what he will do? Okay, it's because he had no one to take care of him. Okay, then Hamid left with the other boys. Hamid was like one with wings on his feet. They ran on ahead of the elders and waited for them under a tree. They reached the suburbs of the town. On both sides of the road were big houses of the rich. In the gardens, mango and lychee trees were full of fruits. Then they came across the stores of the sweets vendors, all decorated so gaily. Every store had sweets piled up in heaps like mountains. Okay, so, but Hamid went out with his friends. Okay, and he was happy also. Like a bird, he flied. Okay, then they ran to the road and they waited under a tree for somebody's, okay, for the elders. And they reached the suburb. Suburbs means it is the outway of the town, okay, city. Okay, so on both sides, it has a big houses. It was a rich place. Okay, then they came across the sweets vendors. Sweets vendors means if they see a sweet vendors means they eagerly waiting to buy, isn't it? So they visited all these shops. Now the shops also decorate in a grand manner for the festival. Now soon the roads began to get crowded. Some people were on tonkas and ekas, some in motor cars, all wearing perfume, all bursting with excitement. The children were a calm and contented lot. For village children, everything in the town was wonderful. Whatever caught their eye, they stood and gaped at with the wonder. At last, the Eidgah came into view. There were row upon row of worshippers as far as the eye could see. Newcomers lined themselves behind the ones already there. Okay, so they reached the place to enjoy, to celebrate the festival with the excitement. Okay, nowadays if the festival means we will go by a car or a cycle or a scooter, any two wheelers, isn't it? Like that, they also went to the place on tongas. Tongas means it is a vehicle, it will pulled by the horse, okay, double horse. Ekas means it is also one of the cart pulled by the horse, but a single horse, okay. And somebody went by the motor cars and they gathered there to celebrate their festival, okay. And the town also decorated in a grand manner, and it has full of stores and everything, and they worship to God, okay. Then they wish everyone. Okay, then the prayer was over. Men embraced each other. They descended on the sweet and toy vendors' stores like an army moving to attack. There was the merry-go-round with wooden elephant, horses and camels. You paid 1 paisa and had 25 rounds of fun. Mahmud and Mohsin and Nuri and other boys mounted the horses and camels. Okay, so they gathered for prayer first. Okay, so once their prayer finished means they will enjoy to start. Okay, start to enjoy. Okay, so the children visited the sweet vendors and the toys. Okay, and some students went for elephant riding and horse riding and camels riding like that. For every moment they should pay the amount, such amount. Okay, then Hamid watched them from a distance. Okay, but Hamid went there, but he didn't mingle with anyone. Okay, just he watched what they are doing. Okay, all he had were 3 paisas, because Hamid had only 3 paisa, so he didn't know what to do. He couldn't part with a third of his treasure for a few miserable rounds. Okay, so he couldn't participate on it. They were soon done with their rides. Then it was time for the toys. His friends finished their rides. Then next they came to buy a toys. There was a row of stalls on one side with all kinds of toys. Soldiers and milkmaids, kings and ministers, water carriers and washerwomen and holy men. Okay, so now they actually means Hamid friends had entered to the shop to buy the toys, like a soldiers and milkmaids, kings and ministers, etc. Mahmud bought a policeman in khaki with a red turban on his head and a gun on his shoulder. Okay, so Mahmud had decided to buy a policeman. Okay, the policeman means he will have a khaki dress and the red turban on his head. Likewise, he wanted to buy a policeman. He bought the policeman. Then Mohsin bought a water carrier, while Nuri got a lawyer. Okay, so Mohsin bought a water carrier. Then Nuri got a lawyer. These are the toys. Okay, those toys cost 2 paisa each. Okay, so they spent 2 paisa for each toys. Then Hamid had only 3 paisas. How could he buy such expensive toys? If they dropped out of his hand, they would be smashed to bits. Okay, so but Hamid had only 3 paisa, so he had worried to buy the toys. He didn't want to buy the toys also. He thought that if they dropped the toys means from their hand means it will be smashed to bits, isn't it? So if a drop of water fell on them, the color would run. Okay, the color will be vanished. The remaining part of the toys only will be there. It would like to be a ugly one. He felt that. But he looked at them hungrily and wished he could hold them in his hands for just a moment or two. Hamid had no paisa to buy the toys, but he wanted to touch the toys from their friends. Okay. After the toys, it was sweets. Okay, so toy section is over. Now Hamid and his friends entered to the sweet section. Okay, someone bought sesame seed candy, others gulab jamuns or halwa. So Hamid's friends enjoyed with the sweets now. They smacked their lips with relish. Only Hamid was left out. Okay, his friends bought the sweets and they enjoyed, but Hamid didn't participate with them. Just he looked them. Okay. Next to the sweet shops, there were a few hardware stores and jewelry shops. Okay, so next to the sweet shop, there were a few hardware stores. Okay, it will be the things, it will be which are useful for the house. Okay, the boys were not interested in anything there. So the little children, they didn't like to go there. So they walked ahead except Hamid. So but Hamid didn't move from them. He was standard. Okay. And it occurred to Hamid that his granny did not have a pair of tongs. Okay, so he was imagined about his granny, how she suffered without tongs. Each time, tongs means it is a vessel to carry the pot which are very hot, means we can use the tongs and we can carry easily. Without tongs, his granny was suffered a lot. Okay, so each time she cooked chapatis, the iron pan burnt her hands. Okay, so without tongs she cooked, so lot of the times her hands burnt. If he bought her a pair of tongs, she would be very pleased. She would never again burn her fingers. It would be a really useful thing to have in the house. So Hamid stopped to look at a pile of tongs at the hardware shop and asked the shopkeeper, how much for this pair of tongs? The shopkeeper looked at him and replied, it's not for you. Okay, so when she looked at tongs, immediately he imagined about his granny. So he wanted to buy the tongs. So but he wanted to know the cost of the tongs. So he entered to the shop and he asked to the shopkeeper how much it is. Okay, but the shopkeeper replied to him, because he was a young boy, a small boy, so how to he buy these things? Okay, so he replied that this is not for you. Okay, but is it for sale or not? So he was asked him, are you keeping these things to sale? Then why should it not be for sale? Okay, it will cost you 6 paisa. Then the shopkeeper replied to him, this is a cost of 6 paisa. But Hamid's had only 3 paisa, isn't it? Hamid's heart sank. Okay, so he felt very sad. Tell me the correct price, he said. So he asked to the shopkeeper again, please tell to the correct price. If I can, I will buy. He thought that, okay, all right, it will be 5 paisa. Take it or leave it. Then shopkeeper told him, it is only 5 paisa. Do you want to buy? Otherwise, you move from here, he said. Okay. Then Hamid said, will you give it to me for 3? Okay. Then he walked away, afraid the shopkeeper would scream at him. Then Hamid said to the shopkeeper, will you give it only 3 paisa? Because Hamid had only 3 paisa, isn't it? So he was asked to the shopkeeper, will you give for 3 paisa? Then he got afraid whether this shopkeeper will get anger, he may scold. So he walked from there. Okay, but the shopkeeper did not scream. Scream means shouted, okay, with anger. Okay, but the shopkeeper didn't do that. On the contrary, he called Hamid back and he gave him the pair of tongs. But for that, but the shopkeeper asked him, I will give. Okay. Then Hamid carried it on his shoulder as if it were a gun to show it to his friends. Okay, so Hamid very proudly he bought this and he carried on his shoulder and he wanted to show to his friends. Okay, Mohsin laughed and said, are you crazy? Then Mohsin, he laughed at him. Okay, he laughed at Hamid and he asked him, are you crazy? What will you do with the tongs? Hamid flung the tongs on the ground and replied, try and throw your water carrier on the ground, it will break. And immediately he replied that it is very useful thing only, and he kept this on the ground and he asked him, if you throw your water carrier on the ground, it will break. Mahmud said, are these tongs some kind of toy? Then Mahmud asked him, is this a toy? Then why not, replied Hamid. Okay, so replied Hamid said, why not? Then place them across your shoulders and it is a gun. Carry them in your hands and it is like a musical instrument carried by singing monks. My tongs are like a tiger among toys. The proudly Hamid said, if you carried it on your shoulder, it is like a gun. If you carry it on your hand, it is a musical instrument. And if you, my tongs are like a tiger. among the toys. Compare with our toys, he said proudly. Then Sami, who had bought a small tambourine, asked, will you exchange them for my tambourine? It is worth 8 paisa. So immediately Sami had a curiosity to buy the tongs from him. So he asked him, will you exchange, shall we exchange these things? But Hamid would not. Hamid was not ready to exchange. The pair of tongs won everyone over to its side. By 11, the village was again filled with excitement. All those who had gone to the fair were back at home. Hamid too returned home as soon as she heard his voice. Granny Amina ran out of the house, picked him up and kissed him. Okay. Then after that incident, everyone returned to their home. Okay. Amina also expected his grandson Hamid. Okay. So when she heard his voice, immediately she came out and kissed him. Okay. Suddenly she noticed the tongs in his hand. Where did you find these tongs? So she noticed his tongs. Then she asked about this. So Hamid replied, I bought them for you. How much did you pay for them? 3 paisa. So her granny was eagerly asking, how much it is, how much you paid for this? Then he replied to her, only 3 paisa I paid for these tongs. You are a stupid child. It is almost noon and you haven't had anything to eat or drink. Couldn't you find anything better in the fair than this pair of iron tongs? Okay, but it is the noon time. You may be hungry and you can get any drink or eatable things you could buy. Why did you buy this? She asked to Hamid. She means his grandmother asked to Hamid. Hamid replied in an injured tone, you burn your fingers on the iron pan, so I bought them. Granny was deeply moved by Hamid's selflessness. She started crying. For the wretched woman, the pair of tongs was as precious as sacks of silver. Hamid replied to her, you are suffering a lot in the kitchen when you cook, so I brought you. So Granny felt his selflessness. So she started to cry. Okay, depends upon her. It is a precious one. Okay, so like Hamid, you should be like that. You should not have a selfishness. You should serve the people who are in need, especially in your home. Okay, thank you.